Hi. So in this session, we are going to discuss the problem reverse a linked list. Okay. So what's the problem? Problem is you are given this linked list. And you have to reverse this linked list. Reversing means you have to change this linked list to this. This is the final output. That means new head of the reverse linked list will be 5. 5's next should become 4. 4's next should become 3. 3's next should become 2. 2's next should become 1. And 1's next should become none. That we need to do. Now, how can we do? I think one simple approach will be a recursive approach. That means your function is, you have to reverse a linked list means, you have to reverse a linked list whose head is this. This you need to do. Now, you can say, hey, let me reverse this linked list. Get me the reverse linked list starting from this head. What will happen? This will become this. I don't know how. This is my induction hypothesis. My head is here. If this linked list is reversed and induction hypothesis give me this reverse linked list or give me the head of this reverse linked list, what I need to do now? I need to reach the last node. I will start from here and reach the last node. I will come here. Let's say its name is current. This one had to move after the next of current. Correct. So, what I need to do? I think I need to do current dot next equal to head. This will do what? This will do this 5, 4, 3, 2. But once next is already 2. That we don't want. Once next should become what? That should become none. So, one extra step after assigning this, I should do head dot next equal to none. So this will become none. So my new linked list will become 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 to none. And in the end, I need to return the head of this linked list. What is that? This. Whatever had come before happening all this, whatever I had come from the induction hypothesis, that will be the same head. So, I will return. Let's say its name was small head. I will return small head. And I am done. I will call the induction hypothesis through this. I will implement the induction step. And my problem will be solved. I will return this small head. What will be my base case? I think I need to stop at element with one element, linked list with one element. That will be what? That will be simple 5. 1 will call 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5 will call 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5 will call 4, 5. 4, 5 will call 5. Now, 5 can do nothing. If I had given you linked list like this, reverse is also same. So, you just need to return this head only. So, if your head dot next is none, don't do anything, just return same head. This is your base case. One thing more, we need to handle one special case. If I had given you none, linked list which is having no element, reverse linked list is also same. That will not be the base case, that will be the special case. If head is none, don't do anything, just return none or just return head only. That both are same things. That is a special case. Now, I think all cases have been handled. Let's try to code this and understand this programmatically. That will give you more clarity. So, what we need to do? I think we need to implement reverse linked list. That means you are given a head of this linked list. You have to reverse this linked list. You made a induction hypothesis like this. Hey, let me reverse this linked list and got a small head from that. This will give you small head like this. You got this small head. What do you need to do? You need to iterate till the last node, but you can't lose the reference of small head because in the end you need to return this small head only. Correct? When 2345 was reversed, it had become 5432. Small head was pointing to 5. If you start traversing through small head, you will lose the reference of small head. You cannot lose that. So you will iterate through what? With some other variable, let's say current equal to small head. You will iterate till what? Till you reach the last node. So you will be reaching till last node when current.next, while current.next is not none. Till it is not none, you will keep on iterating like this. You will keep on iterating and you reach the last node. Now you reach the last node, what you need to do? So 5 4 3 2, 1 is here, 1's next is 2. First you need to make 2's next as 1. So that means current dot next equal to head and 1's next should become none. That means head dot next equal to none, and you have reversed the linked list. You just need to return the head of that linked list, and that is small head only. This is your induction step. This is your induction hypothesis. You have a base case like this. If head dot next is not none, if head dot next is none, just return head only. This is your base case. Let's handle special case also here. If head is none or head dot next is none, just return head. Okay. If head is none, you will return none. If head dot next is none, you will return the head. This is base case and special case handled in one line. And I think your code is completed. Whatever we had discussed, just wrote the code programmatically. Now, let's try to test this. Before printing the linked list, I had taken input. Whatever link input I had taken, I will reverse that linked list. That means this. I would get the head of the reverse linked list and I will print that linked list. Okay, this we will do. Now, let's try to run this and we are getting reversed linked list. That means if I had given the input 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, my reverse linked list is 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and everything is working fine. Okay. So, let's dry run for a smaller case. Let's say I had to reverse 1, 2, 3, no none. So, what is happening? Head is here. Reverse linked list for 1 has called. Now it has called on 2, 3. Head is here. It has called on 3. Head is here. Now if head is none or head dot next is none, since head dot next is none, it will return the head. It will return to this in this function, and in this function, small head will become 3. Current equal to small head. So, current will be 3, while current dot next is not none. When I had returned this, 3's next was none, so it will not work. Now, current dot next, current is here, not on 2, it is on 3. Current dot next equal to head, that means 3's next will become 2, and you had returned head dot next equal to none. So, this will get removed and it will become this, and you had returned small head, so it will return small head to this. This will be the small head. Now when 1, 2, 3 was called, in 1's small head 3 would have come. Small head is 3 here and linked list has become 3 to 2 none. This is my reverse linked list. Now while current equal to small head, so current will point here. While current dot next is not none, current equal to current dot next. So current will start pointing here. Current dot next is not none. Now current dot next is none. You will stop here. Current dot next equal to head. One is here. 2's next will become 1 and head dot next equal to none. That means 1's next would become none and you had returned small head. It had returned small head to the calling function. Okay, so that 3 is returned. Now you had called this through this. Here 3 had come and you had printed the linked list. The linked list had become 3 to 1 and you had just printed that linked list. So everything is working fine. Try to analyze the time complexity of the solution and see if you can do in a more better way. Okay, so you will be able to do that. We will discuss that, but in the next session. Okay, thank you.